He even invented his own lightsabers for this shit. Good afternoon, everyone. Zack Snyder's Rebel Moon official teaser trailer. Let's get to it. Interesting. A Netflix original drama.
Do you know the story of the Princess Issa? In myth, she was called the Redeemer. It was said this child would stop the madness of war. That she was to usher in a new age of peace and compassion. I was given memories of a world I will never see. Loyalty to a king I cannot serve. And love for a child I could not save.
What do you think they want?
Everything.
I found her. The Scar Giver.
I am a child of war.
What was her name?
I was taught that love is weakness.
Yeah, whoa! What the shit?
Justice and revenge.
That is weird. That is weird.
There is a price to pay for your defiance. Shh. One moment. I do love this part.
Hold on.
I don't want no trouble.
We're not here to bring any.
Are you ready?
Director Zack Snyder.
You and I both know fear. Let's show them that we're not afraid. Let's show them we are more than the shackles that bind us.
Slow motion. Right, slow motion.
A king is a man, and a man can fail. But a myth is indestructible.
The time has come for all that you love. Protect each other and show them no mercy.
Hell yeah. What the hell? He even invented his own lightsabers for this shit.
For what you believe.
Part 1. Part 2. The Scar Game. 2024. Oh, okay, so they're releasing within months of each other. They're not releasing like a whole last year or something like that. Okay, so that's going to be an interesting set of events. Okay, so I'm definitely getting some Star Wars vibes, and I know the story of Rebel Moon. Okay, so basically, Zack Snyder was approached one time to create a Star Wars movie, but he wanted it to make like an R-rated version of it. And understandably, Lucasfilm was like, no, you're not making an R-rated Star Wars movie, because why the hell would you ever want to greenlight an R-rated Star Wars movie? You know, something that's mostly tailored to young adults. Yes, I know people don't like it when I say Star Wars is a film, this is a kids movie and everything. And I'm like, I don't like it. I don't like it when people say that shit. But it is pretty obvious that Star Wars is tailored towards kids and towards young adults, and you know, children do like watching this stuff. So of course they said no to Zack Snyder, and Zack Snyder was like, okay, I'll make my own Star Wars. Quite frankly, I got more of a Dune vibe from this than I did Star Wars, actually. And it's like my friend said earlier, like I talked to my friend the other day. He said that he got more of a Dune vibe from watching the commercial of this, and then he thought of me, of course, because I like Dune. So far, this looks good and everything. Some people still think that Zack Snyder should have directed Star Wars. I'm like, nah. Like, I'm sorry, but Zack Snyder and Star Wars just doesn't mix. I mean, See, I mean, look at this. Like, I get Star Wars vibes, but I'm not getting that much of a Star Wars vibe in this shit. Like, it's very much inspired by Star Wars, but it's completely different. I still don't think it's a good idea for Zack Snyder to do anything Star Wars related. It's kind of like how people think Christopher Nolan should direct a Star Wars movie. I'm like, no, that is a bad idea. Because Christopher Nolan, he's just doing his own thing, all right? He does his own thing, and he has his own style that does not correlate to Star Wars. I mean, yeah, you can point to Interstellar, but dude, I argue Interstellar is nothing like Star Wars, man. Oh, well. To each their own, I guess. I kind of like this trailer. I'm kind of looking forward to it. And what do you guys think about it? Comment below if you like, subscribe if you like, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.